I'll give you 10 minutes to do that, and then we'll get started with today's lesson. If you already turned in your worksheets, then you should be opening up your Chromebooks to the video that's on the next slide. All calculatorpros.com so that you're more familiar with the calculator that we use on tests. So if you go to desmos.com and then you click graphing calculator, you can type both of these equations into the calculator. When you do that, you should notice that you see either this shape or this shape. So, and I'll walk you through it. All right, going to desmos.com. Graphing calculator. And typing in the equation that we have on our examples. So x squared plus 2x minus 5. All right, so notice if I were like to backspace, it does move the graph. So like that, like it's still a parabola. But when I enter the whole thing, that gives me the specific parabola for this function. So if you were to sketch that on your paper in your notes section, you would have a point somewhere down here, so like in this quadrant of the graph, and the u would be curving upward. All right, so then filling that in when you sketch your graph. Have a point somewhere down here, and the graph looks something like this. All right, whenever you have the x squared as a positive number, so if a is positive, then the parabola opens up like a smile. So like when positive things happen, like you get paid or when you get a compliment, you curve up like a smile, right? So that can help you remember that the positive coefficients give you a positive parabola. Now if I enter this into my graphing calculator, so go ahead and enter that in. Notice that the x squared is now negative. What do you notice about how that one looks? How is it different from this one? It goes down, right? The arrows point downward, kind of like this one. All right, when you enter that in, you should have a vertex, and we'll talk more about that. You should have a point right here, the top of your parabola, and then it should curve outward like this. Just like a rough sketch. So when your x squared value is negative, the parabola opens down like a frown. Any questions about that one? So even if I don't use this specific example, I go back to Desmos and I just enter negative in front of that x squared, well, now the graph flipped. So then we also have new terms like axis of symmetry. So that's going to be the vertical line that divides the parabola into two equal parts. So the vertical line that divides the parabola into two equal parts. All right, so axis of symmetry. When something is symmetrical, it's the same on both sides, right? So my axis of symmetry will just be wherever like the middle portion of my graph is. So if this was the middle portion, it would go down like that. If this was my middle portion, the axis of symmetry would just be a straight line dividing it equally. All right, you could identify it graphically, but then some students kind of mess up the formula. So here's a way to solve for it algebraically. All right, the formula for your axis of symmetry is going to be x equals negative b over 2 times a. And you'll see that again later on for something different that we use. But for axis of symmetry, you'll use this formula to calculate it algebraically. So since standard form is ax squared plus bx plus c, I would take whatever number is in the b position and put it here. And then I would take whatever number is in the a position and put it where the a is. All right, and that'll give me my axis of symmetry. All right, last new vocabulary word for today is vertex, which is going to be the turning point of the parabola. So the turning point of the parabola. So it either will be the highest point or the lowest point, it just depends. If your graph is negative or positive. So if it's at the lowest point, your vertex is going to be called a minimum. All right, so that's the minimum point of the graph. And then if it's at the highest point, that's going to be a maximum. Alright, so minimum and maximum for the vertex. Alright, so now we get into actual examples that look just like your homework, so we'll spend some time on these, and then you should have the rest of your time for your practice. Alright, so first example. First, any questions on the vocabulary? All right, so first example, I have y equals x squared plus 8x plus 15. So first thing it asks me for is my axis of symmetry. My formula for axis of symmetry is up here, so I'm just going to copy it over. X equals negative b over 2a. Over here, I'm going to identify what my a value and my b values are. And while we're at it, we'll identify the c value, even though we don't use it in this formula. So what number is in the a position for the quadratic function?
X to the second.
So what number is in front of the x to the second?
One.
All right, so that's going to be my a value is 1. What's my b value? 8. And what's my c value? 15. All right, plug that into your formula. So I have a negative, because that's what it was in the formula. B, so my b value is 8. And then that's over 2 times a. What was my a value? 1. All right, and this we can simplify. So I have negative 8 over 2 times 1. What's that? 2. And then what's negative 8 divided by 2? Negative 4. So then my axis of symmetry is x equals negative 4. All right, don't forget the x equals because it's a line. It's the equation of a line.
There's just a few people ahead of you.
Michaela, did you go already?
Yeah. You can go back.
Alright, so that's my axis of symmetry using the formula from our vocabulary. Alright, now the vertex is gonna be the point that the graph turns, right? So it's gonna be either the highest or the lowest point. Here's how you can solve it algebraically, and then I'll show you how to find the vertex graphically. Since this is my formula for quadratic functions, y equals x squared plus 8x plus 15, and we solved for what x equals. So what does x equal? Good. I can replace that all the x's with a negative 4. So I have negative 4 squared plus 8 times negative 4 plus 15. All right, you could solve this by hand, or you could save some time and enter it into the calculator. So I'll show you that on Desmos. Going back to my paper, we get y equals negative 1. And then when we write our vertex, it's going to be in the xy form. So I'm going to have parentheses, negative 4, comma, my y value, which is negative 1. Alright, questions of how we found that? So that's for finding the vertex, is plugging it into the equation that you were given. Last thing would be to sketch it. So I'm perfectly fine with you using the graphing calculator to do that. So you could just type in the equation that you're given. So y equals x squared plus 8x plus 15. And what I'll be looking for is, do you have the parabola facing the correct direction? Do you have the vertex in the right spot? Do you have the axis symmetry in the right spot? All right, that'll get you all the points on the quiz or like on the homework. All right, so copy this onto your paper with the vertex about here, so in this quadrant. Ready to try one? All right, let me see which one you should try. Do number 3 next. All right, we'll do 2 together. Try number 3 on the back side of your note sheet. Thank you. write down the formula that we wrote together in the vocabulary, and then plug in the given information. What is my B value over here? Negative 12, good. So my B value is negative 12. What's my A value? 3. Right, so these are the numbers that I'll be plugging in. And in my formula, it has a negative B, so negative, and then plug in your B value, over 2 times A, so plug in your A. All right, what happens to the double negative in the numerator? It turns into a positive. So since it was negative in the formula, in the given equation, and it's negative in the formula, it does cancel out to a positive. In the denominator, 2 times 3 is 6. All right, simplify that. 12 divided by 6 is 2. Sorry. 12 divided by 6 is 2. So when we write our axis of symmetry, write it as x equals 2. All right. What did you get as your vertex?
2
and your y value was
17.
Does that sound right? All right, let's see. If I plug it into my formula, I put 2 for all of the x's. So 3 times 2x squared minus 12 times 2 plus 5. And I enter this in the calculator exactly how it looks on my paper with the parentheses and everything. I actually don't know the answer off the top of my head, so let me look at my answer key. I do not get 17. What do I get instead? I get negative 7. Alright, so let's see how we entered it. It's fine if you do it by hand, but I would still check my answer in the calculator. So,
3 times 2
down to the parentheses and everything, I get negative 7 as my y value. All right, and then when I enter my formula into Desmos just to check that I did everything correctly, and I hover over that point on the graph, so down here, can everyone see that? Or even on their own screen. When I hover over that point, it does say 2, comma, negative 7. All right, so know how to do it both ways, but use the graphing calculator to check. All right, any questions about that?
Kaden, did you already?
All right, and then to sketch your graph, it goes upward. Axis of symmetry is at x equals 2, and your vertex, that point right here, is 2, negative 7. All right, want to try number 2 where it's negative? All right, so try number 2. If this is pretty easy, then we'll do the practice afterward, after this one. So try number 2 on your note sheet.
Because a negative divided by a negative gives you.
A positive.
Yeah.
But
That's what it's
this
supposed
is
to
a
be.
negative one.
So this right here is just for the axis of symmetry. So all that tells you is that it's gonna like separate in half where x is 5.
Yeah, but then you have to put the x instead of 5 for x.
So when you plug that in for the x, you get 5 squared, which is 25,
okay,
times negative 1.
Give you about 30 more seconds for number 2. If you're already finished with that, you should be moving on to the practice.
So for this one, you should only be factoring the GCF for this first section. So no, you don't go any further. And then it is your turn. Your vertex is right, then you have the axis of symmetry is right.
So the 32 is literally
the 52 just tells you like the y value of your vertex.
Oh.
So like if you didn't have a graph calculator, that tells you like where the graph starts.
working on right now? Okay, then wait a second. Alright, gonna ask you to stop talking in 3, 2, and 1. Alright, so formula for axis of symmetry, I would write it every time. So this is what we got from the notes. What is my b value that's in the equation?
10.
And what is my a value?
-1.
So plug it into the formula, use your parentheses if you need to, so that way you're not making any mistakes. Alright, so this top part becomes a -10 because the negative in the formula. And then 2 times -1 gives me -2. Now what's -10 divided by -2? A positive 5. Alright, I did see a few -5s, so just make sure that we check it in our Desmos graphing calculator, or, you know, just remember negative divided by negative gives you a positive. Alright, so good on that part. How can I figure out what my vertex is algebraically? Good. So I take this formula that I was given originally, kind of like how we did last semester, and we plug in 5 anywhere that there's an x. Alright, by doing that and simplifying it, that gives us our y value. Because since our vertex is in the format x, y, well, we know what our x is, right? What did we say x was? 5. Then by entering that in the calculator, we get our y value. All right, I'll show you how to enter it in the calculator because I did see some mistakes. But what is the correct answer? 2. All right, should be just 2, not 52. Alright, so let's see that in action. Right, see if it matches up with your answer. questions? Ready to work on the practice? Yes, maybe? Alright, so just evens or odds on the practice. I'm thinking that's enough time for you to be able to finish it. And the answer key is on the back wall for you to check your answers. Who else asked me for the restroom? Was that it? Yes? Right here, where this was a negative 12 for the b value, when I plug it into the formula for axis of symmetry, I get a negative negative 12. So that makes it a positive 12 because a double negative gives you a positive. brought up a good point that I didn't go over, but we can go over it right now. What if you have parts missing, like, in your equation? So, like, in number 7, I don't have a constant. I do have my A and B value, though, but if I needed my C value for something, what would my C value be?
Zero.
Right? We just don't write it when it's zero, but if that were the case, my C value would be zero. What about in 8? What value am I missing? My A, B, or C value?
C.
You're missing the B value. You're missing the one that goes in front of the X, right? So what would be the B value if it wasn't even there at all, the X term? My B value would be zero, which you can still plug into your formula. So things like that. Any questions about that? So if I was still solving this one on my notes, I would enter a negative 0 over 2 times a, which a happens to be 1. We get 0 divided by 2, which is just 0. All right, so that's what you'll do in those situations.